radio signals come from many places and objects, including faraway stars and galaxies. These signals are received by the many antennas in the Murchison Wildfield Array, or MWA, a radio telescope located in outback Western Australia on Wadjuri country. Each antenna is a crossed pair of bowtie-shaped elements made of aluminium, with a wingspan of 74 centimetres. This dipole design is sensitive to radio signal frequencies between 70 and 300 megahertz. Each antenna contains a low noise amplifier chip, or LNA. The LNA amplifies the very small radio signals from space. The antennas are grouped into tiles, each one a 4x4 square grid. The MWA telescope has hundreds of tiles, meaning thousands of antennas, spread over several kilometres. The radio signals received by each tile are passed to a beamformer. This device applies time delays to the signals of each antenna to steer its beam in a particular direction. In this way, the MWA can be pointed in any direction, despite having no moving parts. The delayed signals are combined, amplified, and sent over coaxial cable to a receiver. The receiver filters and digitizes the signals so they can be read by computers. The signals are then processed on-site by the MWA's correlator. The correlator is a huge computer bank which performs the mathematical operations to combine the data from all the tiles in the MWA telescope. The correlated data then travels on a dedicated fibre to Perth, over 600 kilometres away. Its first stop is Curtin University, where it is held in temporary cache storage. The data is then transferred to the Pawsey Supercomputing Research Centre, which hosts the entire MWA data archive. From here, scientists around the world can access this data through an online platform, the MWA node of the All Sky Virtual Observatory. The tiny radio signals received by the MWA have contributed to enormous discoveries, stretching as far back as the beginning of the universe.